We all have experience in education, in higher education. And if you give me the following task, now I am the rector of National University of Political Studies and Public Administration in Bucharest. Our university, it's a medium, if not small university. We have 6,000 students. 99% of programs are regular program, face-to-face. Now we are online due to the COVID situation. If you give me a very simple task to host, to accommodate in my university more other 400 students, I don't think I'll be able to do it. Or at least I'll not be able to do it quite soon for many reasons. From the capacity issue, like classes, whatever, to professors, to quality assurance standards, and so on. But we are talking in this conference about access and equity, about being smart enough to build a system that will accommodate 40 million or 100 million more students in the next decades. If I am not able to address the issue with 400 students in my university, the question is how we are going to address, using the same models of higher education, the issue of millions of new students. So summing up, in short, this is a question. Sure, we have philosophy of education, why we are building educational system. We are speaking about the bright future of our kids and of our country. We are speaking about very sophisticated system of quality assurance, accreditation, recognition of diploma. We are speaking about ranking. We are speaking about teachers, and generally the best teachers are not higher education, university professors, are not the one working with the most number, the biggest number of students, but are the one being cited by different other academics. So the research prestige, which is good, I fully support and understand, but this will not meet our dilemma here. So this is, again, very shortly, the question which we are trying to answer.